You know, these losses are not like the losses that we've had in the past, where it's like you get on the bus and you're looking around like, what just happened? Like, how do we even have a chance to, you know, play these guys? These losses, they're not like that. You know, we had opportunities to win these games. We play well in these games, just not well enough to win. And I think, it really motivates everybody to play better.
The Broncos welcome in their rivals, the Las Vegas Raiders, in a matchup of a pair of 3-2 teams, and we are getting you ready for kickoff. I'm Phil Milani alongside Sidney Jones and Eric Dalala. Guys, a familiar problem that keeps popping up for this Broncos team is a slow start on offense. How can they get off to a quicker, faster pace here to start this week?
Yeah, Phil, I think that's been one of our biggest concerns in my eyes throughout the season. I mean, they've talked about getting off to a faster start week in and week out throughout the first 5 weeks. And, you know, the Broncos, they rank 25th in the league in first quarter points with just 13 so far. But I think Teddy said it best this week. I mean, he talked about it in his press conference. He said it starts in practice, starts in the meeting rooms. It starts when they enter the building. You know, he said that there's a sense of urgency around the building, you know, in the meeting room. So I think they need to translate that to the field. And hopefully that's something that we see this weekend. But at least, you know, they're good at coming out in the second half and making adjustments.
That's true. Not sure if you want to be good at that, though. But yeah, the Broncos have fallen behind early in the last couple of games here. They've only scored a field goal once on the opening drive so far this season. The last time they scored an opening drive touchdown way back in 2019. Eric, that's got to change.
Yeah, 24 consecutive games, I believe, without an opening drive touchdown. Longest streak in the NFL. You have to fix that, and I wonder how much of that, Phil, is being a little bit less predictable here on these early drives. I think the first four drives of the game, Broncos went run, run, pass to start these series. You got to keep it a little bit off balance, and I know that there's kind of this back and forth between, hey, do we stick with the run? Do we throw the football on first down? Because against the Ravens, the Broncos did go down the field on first down, but I think you got to find a nice in between not being too predictable, kind of with your play calling, and also being able to hit on some of those shots. Maybe some passes that are a little bit more intermediate could help, but you talk about getting off to a fast start. If you can do that, give your defense a lead to play with here for the first time in what feels like several weeks, I think that could be a big difference maker.
Yeah, if you don't run in enough, you get criticized. If you run it too much, you get criticized. The lose-lose, unless you're scoring on those drives. Here's what Teddy Bridgewater had to say this week.
It starts in practice. Everything starts in practice. And, you know, it starts in, you know, the meeting rooms, when you enter the facility, just having that sense of urgency. So it'll definitely be, you know, something we get going in practice. You can sense the urgency around here in meetings right now. So, it's definitely something we can practice.
Guys, things haven't been much better on the other side of the ball. The Broncos given up some deep shots here the last couple of weeks. Lamar Jackson, Ben Roethlisberger taking advantage of some things here. But Ronald Darby might be back this week. Vic Fangio said it's possible to put him in the starting lineup. Where does he fit, Sidney?
Yeah, well, Phil, I have to say, I think this week is perfect timing for Ronald Darby to come back just because this Raiders offense is loaded with talent. Obviously, like you just said, you know, our secondary did struggle against the Steelers last week. So I think regardless, Ronald Darby being back is going to help this defense. Not really sure how Vic's going to utilize Ronald Darby with Pat Surtain and Kyle Fuller. Obviously, that's going to be up to head coach Vic Fangio and his staff to decide before Sunday. But maybe we could see Pat Surtain going up against Darren Waller like we saw in week one with him going up against Kyle Rudolph, with obviously Darby and Fuller on the outside. But regardless, it's going to be exciting to see him back in action on Sunday.
Yeah, he missed the last four games with a hamstring injury. Kyle Fuller has been picked on a little bit the last couple of weeks. Derek Carr comes in the second best passer in the NFL in terms of passing yards. Eric, do you think it's time that they make a move with Fuller?
Yeah, I mean, I think part of it is you just cannot take Pat Surtain off the field. He's too good. He's been playing really well. Vic Fangio said last week he's been everything we hoped for. So it's not all about Kyle Fuller. I just think the way Pat has played, you can't afford to take him out at any point. He should play almost every single snap. So when you look at the base defense, what I would do, and like Sidney said, we won't know until the very end of the week what's going to happen, but I would keep Ronald Darby in base. He's kind of one of your better coverage guys in man-to-man. I think you like what he and Pat Surtain can do together. And then in the nickel, I think it's going to be hard to take Bryce Callahan off the field because he's so good in the slot. And then when you get to dime, which Sidney mentioned, it'll be interesting to see, do they move Pat Surtain from the outside to play over a tight end, or do they keep him out there and see if somebody else can cover Darren Waller. That, to me, is kind of the unknown.
Darren Waller, obviously a big problem, and they'll have to figure out how to match his physicality and his speed. Vic Fangio said that he's like a wide receiver in a tight end's body, so definitely a mismatch there, whoever is on him. You know what else would help? Maybe a pass rush. Von Miller shut out last week. Here's what he had to say this week.
You know, he's one of my favorite quarterbacks in the league. You know, he's a hell of a player. I got a lot of respect for him. You know, over the years, you know, at first you just want to sack the guy and, you know, you just want to sack him and trash him and do sack dances and stuff. But over the years, you know, you just kind of gain, you know, respect for all of these guys. I know for me, you know, playing these guys for so many years, you just gain this camaraderie and this respect for guys, even if they're on other teams. And, you know, I really respect Derek Gaines. He said a lot of great things about me. I say a lot of great things about him. You know, I want him to do well. I want him to, you know, pass for all the yards in the world, just not against the Broncos.
This a matchup of 2-3-2 teams with almost identical ways to starting the season, 3 wins and then 2 losses. But this matchup really took a weird turn this week. Obviously, John Gruden resigning at the start of this week. Some disgusting, terrible emails. But from a football perspective, Sydney, that really threw a wrench into this week's preparations.
It certainly did, Phil. But, you know, I don't think that we're going to come out here and see a Raiders team that's really very different that we've seen throughout the first 5 weeks of the season. I mean, obviously they're going to have a different offensive play caller, but I don't think they're going to come out and change anything schematically, drastically, you know. So I think Teddy said it best on when he was asked, you know, what can you expect from this Raiders team after, you know, Gruden resigned, and he said that, you know, he's just going to expect Derek Carr to come out and lead this team. He's going to come out and get these guys in focus and really rally these guys. So I think we're going to see a Raiders team that has had a really hot start to the season, and obviously Derek Carr, we're going to see him come out and play as he often does very well against Denver.
But there was a reason why the Raiders paid John Gruden $100 million, 10-year deal there. One of the better play callers traditionally in the NFL. Eric, how much is this going to change what Denver wants to do?
It shouldn't change anything that Denver does. I mean, I do think the Raiders have struggled offensively the last few weeks, so you need to come out ready at the beginning of the game and defensively continue those struggles. I think if there's one thing that you tend to see with teams that have an interim head coach is they have that emotional boost early in the game. They come out fast. Denver has to be ready to match that, which they did not do in Pittsburgh. I think this is a team, Phil, that if you can come out and get ahead early, maybe take a double-digit lead into halftime or something like that, it could be a team that you see kind of fade away in the second half. But if the Raiders come out to a hot start, you're not able to match that. It's going to be a very close game. Could be difficult to earn a win that they really desperately need.
They really need to, the season may be at a crossroads right now. I know we've said that all week long. That's the football side of things. Broncos head coach Vic Fangio was asked what his reaction was to the emails.
I just think there's no place in the world, let alone our league, you know, for the opinions that were expressed then, and especially the words used to express those opinions. And, you know, myself and the organization are definitely against that. And, you know, it was a bad situation.
All right, my favorite time of the show. I think it's your favorite time of the show, and I think it's your favorite time of the show. Score predictions. Sydney, let's hear it.
Okay, Phil. I'm going to go Broncos win, of course, always. I'm not switching that up this week yet, guys. I'm going to say 27-20.
Okay, 27-20. Yep. Any reason why that score?
No, it's just kind of how I'm feeling,
Sometimes all you need is a gut feeling.
Gut feeling, right.
Okay, I like it. Eric?
Yeah, I think 24-17, same margin of victory there for the Broncos. I think Justin Simmons has been talking for weeks. Can they make that final stand? I think it's going to come down to the final drive. The Broncos defense rebounds. They get it done. They're able to earn a win at home. A
couple Broncos wins. I was going to say Raiders when I first started thinking about it, but with John Gruden resigning this week, that really threw things in a different direction. I say 24-23. Guys, I'm not sure if you know this. The last 3 games in Denver in this series, all 1-point margins. I'm going to say it's 4 now. I'm going to say 24-23 Broncos get the victory. What do you think?
I like it.
Okay, we'll have to see. We'll have to see what happens. That is going to do it for us. For Eric Dalala and Sydney Jones, I'm Phil Milani. This has been Ready for Kickoff.